Hello everyone, Mike here, and today I have a bit of a fan theory for you. This is something that I came up with just recently, which is funny because I've seen this movie I don't even know how many times. And I want to preface this. This is only based on the movies themselves. I know there are like books that talk about Jason's dad and all that stuff. None of that. This is only based on the movie. And as such, Friday the 13th, Part 1, of course, is pretty well known for not actually being Jason. Except, I think it is. I don't think Pamela Voorhees is the killer in Friday the 13th. Now, there is an exception. The pre-credit scene where they have the two counselors getting ready to have sex, and then, you know, the point of view going in. They know her. So obviously that one, yes, that is her. But then we move on to, you know, many years later, where the main crux of the story takes place. And I don't think it's Pamela Voorhees. I think she's behind it, but I don't think she's the one doing the killing. The main reason, there's a couple. One, when we do see the killer, obviously we only see like either the hand or we see the torso. Now, obviously this is done for the whodunit element, so you're not meant to really think about it. But I believe, well, I shouldn't really say I believe. Those are not women. That is not a woman's arm. That is not a woman's torso. That is part of what makes me say it's not Mrs. Voorhees. Other thing is a lot of the kills require a lot of physical strength that I don't think she could do. Not because she's a woman, but because she is a middle-aged woman who does not look to have a lot of real physical strength to her. So that brings the question then, if she's not the killer, who is? Well, Jason. A lot of people would say, but in Friday the 13th Part 1, he's a child. We see him at the end come out of the lake and drag Alice down in there. Well, one, that's a dream sequence. Two, Friday the 13th Part 2, the initial scene takes place just a few months after the first one. And Jason in this is a full-grown man when he kills Alice. So if he was a full-grown man there, why would he be a child in the first one? Although, yeah, this brings up, how would he have grown if he was a child when he drowned? Now, this, of course, brings up, you know, how was he an adult throughout all of the movies? Well, I think I have a bit of a no prize as for how this happened, how Jason came back initially, and why he is an adult.
All right, gonna use evil rituals to bring back my son. I can't see this going bad at all. All right, gonna see. I'm gonna get back my son.
To get that which you desire, something must be given.
I got this DVD of the first Doctor. I mean, DVDs don't even exist yet.
Sweet, you got a deal.
Awesome.
Yeah, I am pretty sure that's exactly what happened. Now this brings us back to the kills. As I said, the kills are, for the most part, very brutal, and the brutality isn't so much what removes her from being able to do it, but again, physically capable. There is one that you could say she did, but I still think was Jason, and that is Steve Christie. Because, of course, you know, Christie comes in, when he dies, he sees Pamela, and, you know, he's like, oh, hey, what are you doing here? And then he gets killed. However, I still have a theory as to why this was also Jason. Or I should say, how this was also Jason.
All right, Jason. Steve's coming. You hide behind that tree. I'm gonna lure him close. And when he gets close enough, you jump out and stab him. All right. Steve, hi!
The other big reason that I don't think it was Pamala Voorhees that was doing the killing is because when we're down to our last final girl, Alice, and Pamela does confront her, how does she choose to attack Alice?
All the other deaths are so brutal. Why are you just slapping me?
Yeah, that is kind of a weird way to go after the last girl. And so you may be asking, well, if Jason was the killer, why would Pamela go after Alice at the end to begin with? Well, I got thoughts on that too.
All right, Jason. That girl's the only one left. You go back, wait for me back at the cabin. I got this. All right. Mom's got this. Yep, Mom's gonna finish this all up. Sure is taking her a while. Maybe I better go check on her. Aw, man! Now I gotta get revenge for her!
So, yeah. I mean, I had a lot of, you know, humor I inserted into this, but the thought remains, I think that the killer in Friday the 13th Part 1 is Jason, not Pamela. But I'd be really interested in hearing what you guys think. Do you agree with me? Do you think the killer was Jason? Do you think it was indeed Pamela Voorhees? Whichever thought you have, why do you think that? I'd be really interested to hear what you guys have to say about it. Well, that's all I've got on this one. So, until next time.